We go to our next speaker, Alexei Moskalov, from the Russian Academy of Sciences, and he will talk also on biomarkers of human aging.
Dear colleagues, dear organizers, thanks a lot for the possibility to join this exciting meeting. Already mentioned that many physiological functions decrease with aging, that functions are related to lung capacity, liver, kidney function, brain, and also skeletal muscle functions. Less known that not only decline of functions reflects aging, but the levels of some functions increase, for example, stress hormone levels. And to study aging, to understand aging, we need biomarkers, some measurable parameters that are reproducibly change with aging of a person. It will help us to predict the accelerated or delayed aging of an individual, to monitor the effectiveness of therapies aimed at preventing aging, including already mentioned diets, lifestyle, geroprotectors, physical activity, etc. Sven already enumerated some biomarker criteria. Most of the most important one, correlation with the biological age of the person, and also prediction of mortality better than chronological age, and the prediction of early stages of specific age-related diseases or multimorbidity. And also biomarkers need to be minimal invasive. I think we need some additional criteria to go to practice for translation. It should be sensitive to early signs of aging, because some kinds of aging biomarkers like frailty index very close to mortality, but not reflect early stages of aging, the stage where we can reverse some changes. And also have a predictive function in the foreseeable period, not in a very long period of life. And they have a low analytic variability and a very high reproducibility. It is very obvious that it is difficult indicator is a biomarker of aging. We need a panel of biomarkers, or I think it's a very important reflection what's the difference between chronological and biological age. Biological age of a person's or the same chronological age are very variable. And also you can change your biological age by interventions. I use this classification of types of biological age, clinical and functional tests, such as anthropological markers like BMI, waist hematological biomarkers, markers of inflammation, insulin resistance, lipid profile, and the chronological markers. Also aging mechanism-based markers, because we know some about the mechanisms of aging, like telomere attrition, lysosomal or mitochondrial dysfunction, cellular senescence, and we can measure these particular processes to understand the biological age of the person. And also omics. If we propose that we don't know anything about the real mechanisms of aging, we can collect big data like metabolomics, transcriptomics, metagenomics, proteomics, methylation of DNA, or also multi-omics to predict a biological age of the person. I would like to discuss shortly the advantages and disadvantages of these kind of markers of biological age. For example, functional markers have a direct clinical interpretation and very useful for doctors. But even if they predict mortality better than passport age, it is unclear to what extent they measure biological aging itself, rather than health deterioration for other reasons. In addition, these markers often only work as averages over very large samples, for example, from wearable devices, etc., and vary greatly from one person to another person. Molecular markers are based on deeper understanding of the molecular and cellular causes of aging, and should theoretically be more sensitive to early signs of aging, as opposed to mortality and frailty. But like clinical markers, they lack stability and reproducibility for specific patients. This is because aging is a multi-level process. Therefore, markers of individual mechanisms cannot cover off its aspects. Omics. In omics are the results of alterations in the body of at different levels, making them a useful way to approach the complexity of the aging process. But we need a reliable harmonized data of omics of many people to make some such models. But multi-omics approaches to assessing the aging rate also take place. We recently published a review paper on multi-omics approaches to human biological age estimation in mechanisms of aging and development. You can look at this paper to go further. In collaboration with the gerontological clinic of Moscow Medical Institution, we looked at collected data of many patients of different ages, which were studied by 86 different parameters of their health, including many hematological parameters, endocrinological, inflammatory, some molecular markers like telomere length, and functional tests. And we applied machine learning to this data and observed that arterial aging parameters, four arterial aging parameters overperformed all other parameters in this study. And we established arterial index model to better predicts biological age in patients with diabetes and hypertension. Now we try to use this model in several small clinical trials. Very good parameter of biological age is frailty index. It's very, very easy to apply from different kinds of medical data. In collaboration with Arnold Mitnitsky from Canada, we applied two kinds of biological age estimations, frailty index and one of the AI bioage approach to COVID patients. And we predicted the risk of death, passport age, and also frailty index and AI bioage using this data. And we observed that age is the most predictable risk estimation for this kind of patients. But frailty index and the AI bioage also are good predictors of mortality in COVID patients. We combined age, passport age, and the frailty index, and obtained more precise risk prediction for mortality in this kind of patients. It's unpublished. I also recommend you to look at our two books published in academic press, Epigenetics of Aging and Longevity, including epigenetic logs, and biomarkers of human aging published in Springer. And also, if you need something less theoretical and more practical, you can join as a tester to our new project, Young AI. You can download the application for your iPhone or go to website to register to this project and learn your biological age with us. Thank you for your attention.
Question from Walter. Alexei, it seems like the attempt to measure biological age is doomed to limited accuracy because it essentially averages a bunch of factors. Some parameters might be in a critical stage and others not. Some might be treated and greatly extended the period of healthy life. Anyone that goes over the age can spell death. Trying to lump them together seems inherently too simplistic. What am I missing?
Thank you for your notion. It's not a question. I think we need a real big data and a multi-omics approaches to deeper understanding of biological age. And we will do it, I think.
Okay. Thank you, Alexei.